Hello everyone, in our heat transfer lecture series, today we are going to discuss on the heat transfer through external force convection. So first we will see about the friction and pressure drag. So the force a flowing fluid exerts on a body in the flow direction is called as the drag force. So if we are given the example, the vehicle is moving in the wind tunnel and the wind will be flow with 60 meter per hour. So in that, the whatever force applied by this air on this vehicle in the flow direction, that force is called as the drag force. And the component of the pressure and the wall shear forces in the normal direction to the flow tend to move the body in that direction, and their sum is called as the lift force. The lift force is when air will be flow over this car, the whatever force applied in perpendicular direction to the flow of the air, that force is called as the lift force. Okay. Now if you see here, we have given a second diagram as the force of flow over a parallel plate. In that, drag force acting on a flat plate parallel to the flow depends on the wall shear only. So if you see, when the flow will be occur over the plate, then friction will be occur, and due to that the shear stress will be developed, and due to that the friction force will be developed. Okay. And the drag force acting on the flat plate normal to the flow depends on the pressure only, and is depend on the wall shear, and it is independent of the wall shear which acts normal to the free steam flow. If you see the second diagram, if a plate is perpendicular to the flow, in that the drag force will be occur due to the pressure force. Okay. Now here, the drag coefficient. The drag coefficient will be calculated by using this formula. The CD is called as the drag coefficient, is equal to FD, frictional drag force, drag force divided by half rho V square into A, the surface area where the flow will be occurs. Okay, so by using this formula we can calculate the drag coefficient, or if you know about the drag coefficient, we can calculate the drag force. The drag force is the net force exerted by the fluid on a body in the direction of flow due to the combined effect of the wall shear and the pressure forces. Okay, we have seen earlier the part of the drag that is due directly to the wall shear stress, tau w, is called the skin friction drag. So if you see here, the frictional drag force will be occur here due to the shear stress occur at the surface of the plate. So that's why the tau shear stress will be developed, and due to that the force, the drag force will be developed, that force is called as a skin friction drag. Okay, since it is caused by frictional effect, and the part that is due to directly pressure P is called the pressure drag. When the friction and pressure drag coefficients are available, the total drag coefficient is determined by simply adding it. So drag force plus the frictional drag force coefficient plus the pressure drag coefficient. Okay. If you are adding this, you will find out the total drag coefficient. Now here, the frictional drag is component of the wall shear force in the direction of the flow, and thus it depends on the orientation of the body as well as the magnitude of the wall shear stress tau w. Okay. The frictional drag is zero for a surface normal to the flow, and the maximum for a surface parallel to the flow, since the frictional drag in this case equal to the total shear force on the surface. Okay. So here if you see, the drag force will be zero when the plate is perpendicular to the flow, and if a plate is parallel to the flow, the drag force is equal to the frictional drag force. Okay, so in first case the drag force will be zero, and in second case the drag force or the friction drag force is equal to frictional drag force, and this is find out the frictional force is equal to coefficient of friction multiply the area rho v squared by 2. Therefore for parallel flow over a flat plate, the drag force drag coefficient is equal to the frictional drag coefficient, or simply the friction coefficient. And for a flat plate, so we have given here the frictional drag force is equal to the frictional, the drag coefficient. This is equal to the frictional coefficient. Now we will find out the heat transfer concepts. First, we already see the Nusselt number, and Nusselt number is depend upon the Reynolds number and Prandtl number. The local and average Nusselt number have the functional form. So this is find out the Nusselt number at the distance x from the leading edge is equal to f1 in bracket x star comma rex comma Prandtl number. That means Nusselt number is a function of the distance from the leading edge, Reynolds number at that point, and the Prandtl number. Okay, so that's why Nusselt number is equal to f2 in bracket, also Nusselt number is a function of the Reynolds number and Prandtl number. The experimental data that for heat transfer is often represented conveniently with a reasonable accuracy by simple power law relation of the form. That means Nusselt number is equal to the C Reynolds number rest to m and Prandtl number rest to n, where m and n are constant exponents and the value of the constant C depends on the geometry of the flow. Okay, and the fluid properties are usually evaluated at the so-called film temperature, and the film temperature will be calculated by using this formula. So film temperature Tf is equal to surface temperature of the plate plus the fluid temperature, free fluid temperature divided by 2. By using this formula, we will find out the film temperature, and that film temperature we will find out the average properties of the fluid. Okay, after find out this one, the average friction and convection coefficients are will be calculated. So by using this formula, we will calculate the average friction coefficient. So CF is equal to average frictional coefficient is equal to 1 upon L integration 0 to L CF of x into dx. By using this, we will find out the average the friction coefficient, and the average heat transfer coefficient will be calculated is equal to 1 upon capital L integration from 0 to L hx into dx. So by using this one, we will find out the average heat transfer coefficient. If you find out the average heat transfer coefficient, then you substitute the value in the heat transfer rate formula to find out the heat transfer. The rate of heat transfer to or from the isothermal surface can be determined from Q dot is equal to HAS TS minus T infinity. So this formula is used when the heat will be transferred from the plate to the film. Now, parallel flow over a flat plate. We will consider here a one plate over that fluid is flowing with a velocity V which has a free steam temperature as T infinity. Okay, and the x direction shows the length of the plate. So total L is indicated the length of the plate. Okay, up to the some distance x from the leading edge, we will getting laminar flow will be converted into turbulent. So we have already seen into the boundary layer formation, velocity boundary layer formation. The first there is a laminar boundary layer, and after some distance the laminar boundary layer will be converted into turbulent boundary layer. Where this laminar boundary layer converted into turbulent boundary layer, that distance will be denoted as x critical. That means in the direction of x, the where the critical value will be found out of this x where laminar flow will convert into turbulent flow. Okay, so here we have shown this Ts as the surface temperature of the plate. Okay, now we see here the Reynolds number at a distance x from the leading edge of the flat plate is expressed as rex is equal to rho v into x divided by mu. So this is equal to you will calculate vx divided by mu. Okay, so v is velocity, x is distance from the leading edge of the plate, and mu is the kinematic viscosity. Okay, the Reynolds number varies for a flat plate along the flow reaching at the end of the plate. So this is calculated Rel is equal to capital V multiplied with capital L divided by nu. So by using this, we will find out the total Reynolds number for this flat plate. And the critical Reynolds number where laminar flow will be converted into turbulent flow, so that will be calculated by using this formula. So if we substitute in previous formula the value of x as x critical, we will find out the Reynolds number at the critical value. So Re critical, Reynolds number critical value is equal to rho capital V x critical divided by mean. So this value for the flat plate we are getting 5 into 10 raised to pi. That means if value will be Reynolds number value will be x6, over this value we will consider this flow is a turbulent flow. If Reynolds number value is less than this value, we will consider that flow as a laminar flow. Now the heat transfer coefficient. The heat transfer coefficient will be calculated for the local Nusselt number at a location x for laminar and turbulent flow over a flat plate is determined by, so Nusselt number x is equal to h of x multiplied with x divided by k. So this is found out by using equal to 0.332 into Reynolds number raised to 0.5, Prandtl number to 1/3, when Prandtl number is greater than 0.6 and Reynolds number is less than 5 into 10 raised to 5. Okay, so this is the formula. Okay, and after experimentation we will see the turbulent for the turbulent case Nusselt number is equal to h of x multiplied with x divided by k is equal to 0.0296, Reynolds number raised to 0.8, Prandtl number is to 1/3, where Prandtl number is lies between 0.6 to 16 and critical Reynolds number is lies between 5 to 10 raised to 5 to 10 raised to 7. If you see here the variation of the local friction and the heat transfer coefficient for a flow over a flat plate, if you see flow will be take place over a flat plate parallel to the flow, if a plate is available parallel to the flow, in that what will happen, Reynolds number, heat transfer coefficient and the frictional drag coefficient will be, in laminar flow it is going to decrease and in transition and turbulent condition it is going to increase up to some value. Okay, now we'll see the average Nusselt number over the entire plate is determined by, okay, so if you substitute by replacing x by l, if you see here Nusselt number is equal to hl by k, l is the length of the plate, so is equal to 0.664 Reynolds number raised to 0.5, Prandtl number is to 1/3, when Reynolds number is lies between 5 is less than 5 to 10 raised to 5 and Prandtl number is less than 0.6. okay, so this formula is used for the region for the laminar flow only. Okay, now for the turbulent flow, if you see here the, in the turbulent flow the flow will be mixes each other, that's why heat transfer rate is going to increase, so that's why the heat transfer coefficient will be increased as compared to the laminar flow. So in that case the Nusselt number will be find out is equal to hl by k is equal to 0.037, Reynolds number raised to 0.8, Prandtl number raised to 1/3, when Prandtl number is lies between 0.6 to 60 and Reynolds number lies between 5 to 10 raised to 5 to 10 raised to 7. Okay, so this formula is particularly used to find out the Nusselt number or the heat transfer coefficient for laminar flow only and the turbulent flow only. If you need to find out the average Nusselt number for all the cases, so this formula is equal to Nusselt number is equal to HL by K is equal to 0.037, Reynolds number raised to 0.8 minus 871 multiply with Prandtl number is to 1/3, and the condition is Prandtl number is lies between 0.6 to 60 and Reynolds number also lies between 5 to 10 raised to 5 to 10 raised to 7. So by using this formula we will find out the Nusselt number, and after finding the Nusselt number we will find out the heat transfer coefficient. So in this formula we substitute the length of the plate and the thermal conductivity of fluid, after that we will find out the heat transfer coefficient. Okay, so this is the main formula to find out the heat transfer coefficient, the flow over parallel flow over the flat plate. Okay, now we'll see the example of our problem regarding the flow of a hot oil over a flat plate. Okay, so we have given the problem as engine oil at a 60 degree Celsius flow over the upper surface of a 5 meter long flat plate whose temperature is 20 degree Celsius with velocity of 2 meter per second. Determine the total drag force and the rate of heat transfer per unit width of the entire plate. Okay, so we have given this example. Oil is flowing with a temperature 60 degree Celsius and velocity is 2 meter per second. Okay, and it is flowing over a plate which is 5 meter long, which has surface temperature 20 degree Celsius. Okay, now we'll see. So we'll first assume something. So assumptions are, the flow is steady and incompressible. Okay. The second, the critical Reynolds number is RE critical is equal to 5 × 10⁵. So that will indicate the flow will be laminar or the turbulent flow. Okay. Now the properties. To find out the properties, first we need to find out the film temperature. So film temperature is equal to TS plus T infinity. TS means surface temperature of the plate plus T infinity is the oil temperature divided by 2. That means average temperature, getting the average temperature will find out the film temperature. So this is equal to 20 plus 60 divided by 2 is equal to 40 degrees Celsius. Now this at the film temperature 40 degrees Celsius, we will find out the properties of the oil, and that properties are density 876 kg per meter cube, Prandtl number 2962, thermal conductivity of oil is equal to 0.144 watt per meter Kelvin, and kinematic viscosity is equal to 2.485 × 10⁻⁴ meter square per second. Okay. Now analysis, in the analysis we will consider length of the plate as 5 meter. At the 5 meter length, we will first find out the Reynolds number. So Reynolds number is equal to, for total plate, velocity multiplied with length divided by kinematic viscosity. So this is equal to 2 meter per second multiplied with 5 meter divided by 2.485 × 10⁻⁴. After that, we will find out the Reynolds number as 4.024 × 10⁴. And if you see, this Reynolds number is less than critical Reynolds number. Okay. So if you see, here is a 10⁴ and here is the 10⁵. So that's why this value is less than the critical Reynolds number. That means the flow is a laminar flow. Okay. So thus we have laminar flow over the entire plate, and the average friction coefficient is C of, the coefficient of friction is equal to 1.33 Reynolds number raised to minus 0.5. So by substituting value, we will see the coefficient of friction is equal to 0.00663. Now here, after finding the coefficient of friction, we will now find out the drag force. So drag force, noting that the pressure drag is 0, and thus the drag force is equal to the frictional force. Coefficient of drag coefficient is equal to frictional coefficient for a parallel flow over a plate. The drag force acting on the plate per unit width becomes, the drag force is equal to C of F multiplied with area, rho V square divided by 2 is equal to 0.00663 multiplied with 5 × 1 meter square area, and the density is 876 multiplied with 2 meter per second velocity square divided by 2, and we will see this value is equal to 58.1 newton. So this is our the frictional force. The total drag force acting on the entire plate can be determined by multiplying the value obtained above the width of the plate. Okay, if you see this formula, this calculation is found out for per width of the plate. If you see here, we have considered only the length as 5 meter. We are not considered the total width of the plate. We have considered only 1 meter the width of the plate. So that's why the frictional force is for the per meter width. Okay. If you multiply with total width of the plate, you will find out the total frictional drag force. Okay. So this force per unit width corresponding to the weight of the mass of the mass of about 6 kg. Therefore, a person who applies an equal and opposite force to the plate to keep it from moving will be feel like he or she is using as much force as is necessary to hold a 6 kg mass from dropping. Okay. So this is the example that this frictional force is for one unit weight. This is regarding the 6 kg. And what means? It means that if one of the person is holding that plate, that means the whatever mass will be applied in downward direction, that same will be force applied by this person to overcome the friction drag force. Now we'll see the Nusselt number is determined using the laminar flow relation. We have already seen the laminar flow relation. So Nusselt number is equal to HL by K is equal to 0.664 Reynolds number raised to 0.5 multiplied Prandtl number is to 1/3. After substituting the value is equal to 0.664 multiplied with Reynolds number 4.024 × 10⁴ rest to 0.5. Multiply with Prandtl number, we have seen that value we have find out by using it at the film temperature. So Prandtl number 2962 raised to 1/3. So after calculating, we will see the Nusselt number is equal to 1913. Okay, now this, by using this one, this value, now we have to calculate the heat transfer coefficient. So heat transfer coefficient is equal to K multiply with thermal conductivity multiply Nusselt number divided by L. So we have seen in previous, we have seen here the Nusselt number formula is equal to HL by K. So in that, if you substitute Nusselt number and multiply with thermal conductivity and divide by length of the plate, we will find out the heat transfer coefficient. So similar one here. Okay, after substituting the value, we will find out the heat transfer coefficient for particular this case is equal to 55.25 W/m² Kelvin. Okay, now we will substitute this heat transfer coefficient into the Newton's law of cooling to find out the rate of heat transfer. So Q dot is equal to HAS T infinity minus TS. In that case, the T infinity is higher than the TS. That means heat transfer will be takes place from oil to the plate. Okay, so H multiply with surface area multiply with the T infinity minus TS. After substituting the values, we will see the heat transfer rate is equal to 11,050 W. Okay, so this is the steps to solve the problems regarding the heat transfer from the flat plate. Okay, thank you.